Now we will have the time dependent and time independent phase difference. What is the use of this time independent phase difference and what is the use of that the time dependent phase difference?
The equation of first ascension. Suppose we are having the two ascension. This y1 equal to a1 sin omega 1 t plus theta 1. A1 is the amplitude. A1 amplitude. And this omega 1 equal to 2 pi n1. N1 is the frequency. The equation of second ascension. Now let us find the phase. The phase phi 1. This is equal to omega 1 t plus theta 1. The equation of second ascension. Now this is equal to y2 equal to a2 sin omega 2t plus theta 2. Theta 2. So now a2 is the amplitude where this a2 equal to amplitude and omega 2 is equal to 2 pi n2. N2 is the frequency. So the phase phi 2 is equal to omega 2t plus theta 2. This is now phase. So now the phase difference. The phase difference. Delta phi is equal to phi 1 minus phi 2. So this is equal to omega 1 t plus theta 1 minus omega 2 t plus theta 2. So this is equal to omega 1 minus omega 2 into t plus theta 1 minus theta 2. This is equal to what? That delta phi. Now you can see from here. There are two cases when omega 1 and omega 2 are equal or not equal. So case 1. If omega 1 is not equal to omega 2, then delta phi is equal to omega 1 minus omega 2 into t plus theta 1 minus theta 2, and this is equal to 2 pi n1 minus n2 into t plus theta 1 minus theta 2. This is equal to delta. Now this phase difference contains the term time t. It is time dependent phase difference. Phase difference as it contains the term t, time.
So this will change with the time. So this is no more a constant phase difference.
It is not a constant phase difference.
So it is time varying phase difference.
So it is time varying.
Such waves cannot be used for the interference of light.
Such waves cannot produce the sustained interference of light and sound.
So these are not helpful. So these such kind of waves having this phase difference are generally emitted by the ordinary light sources
or ordinary light oblique sound sources. Time-dependent emit the waves of time-dependent phase difference.
So now in case of light, we can have the simple, the ordinary light sources.
So the example are your sun, bulb, and the candle, etc.
So the light sound sources also, the ordinary light sound sources also emit the sound waves of varying time. So they are not used to produce the sustained interference. Now case 2.
Now if omega 1 equal to omega 2 or n1 equal to n2. Then delta phi is equal to theta 1 minus theta 2.
And you see that this is not contained in the time term.
This phase difference is independent of time.
So this is a constant phase difference.
So it is constant phase difference.
Constant phase difference. And such waves whose phase difference is independent of time, they are used for the study of interference.
The waves having constant phase difference produce sustained interference. Sustained interference.
So in case of light, they are obtained by certain physical methods. And in case of sound, we are having the two sound sources having the same frequency. It means what, that the frequency of the two sound sources must be equal, only then the phase difference between them will be independent of the time. In case of light, we are having the two light sources of the same frequency. So this phase difference is independent of time, and that they can produce the sustained interference. This is why that such kind of waves are employed to study the interference phenomenon.
Example, two sound source of same frequency and similarly we can have the Young's double slit experiment.
So these are the, so many there are examples of this kind that can be used to produce the interference of the sound and the interference of the light. So this is what the meaning of the time dependent and time independent. So as the name suggests, time dependent means the phase difference which have the time term and that varies with the time, and time independent means the phase difference that have no time. So it is a constant with time, it is not changing at all. So these are called the coherent waves, and such waves are used to produce the sustained interference in case of the sound and also in case of the light. So thank you very much.